I love the arts, specifically music. I don't even know how to start this video. Reminder, this video is the 12th video of the Summer Book Club that Heather from A Catholic Mom's Life is hosting. And the chapter from this book is all about creativity. I love the arts, specifically music, so much. And I want to tell you how much I love being creative and how supportive I am of the arts, and just leave it at that. I'm just gonna tell you some other things too. I am a classically trained professional musician, and I lived in a major city for college and after college. So over a decade, I lived in a big city. So I had a lot of performing opportunities. I taught voice lessons and I enjoyed it very much. But at one point in my life, in my younger days, I did put music above God. Without realizing it, I was seeking my fulfillment from music. Music is such a beautiful force in the world, such a beautiful gift from God. It allows people from all over the world to communicate. It promotes peace and understanding, healing. I did this amazing concert that told the story of Holocaust victims who utilize music to give them the courage to hold on to life and to hold on one more day and to live. The music helped them live. And so when you have something like music that is just so beautiful, you can run into putting it above everything else in your life. And I'm so glad that I've learned that even though there are such beautiful things in the world, nothing fulfills us like God does. I was getting frustrated with music. There are a lot of big egos in music. A lot of people outside of music don't understand, like they think it's a hobby. I mean, just because you have a gig and, you know, it's a modest stipend doesn't mean that it's a hobby. Just because someone off the street can sing Row, Row, Row Your Boat, that doesn't compare to the professional singers who can sing Palestrina and Talis and Bird and can sight read that music and perform it, you know, after seeing it for just 20 minutes or so. So those two things are very different. So it's just very frustrating that people think that, oh, I can sing in the shower, so why do you get paid to do this? It's so frustrating. And I used to get frustrated with musicians as well because, you know, some musicians only hang out with musicians and they only talk about music and acoustics and teaching and repertoire, and I would get frustrated because I was like, oh, there's more to life than music. I love music too. Love music very much, but there is more to life. And now I kind of empathize with those musicians because I know that a lot of people outside of music don't really respect or understand musicians, and that's really aggravating. Another part of living as a professional musician that I didn't like was just the rat race of it all. We were taught, if you get one gig out of every 50 auditions, you are doing fabulous. So we were supposed to be auditioning all the time. And once we got a gig, we weren't supposed to rest. Once you get a job, you are supposed to still be auditioning for your next job during your first job. So like there was no rest. I was completely restless. And I did enjoy that for a few years. Like, I just loved performing so much, but it really is true what the Catholic Church teaches, that nothing in this world fulfills us. Only God can fulfill us, and I've really found that to be true. I was so restless and so tired, and I have found peace in the Lord. There are artists, musicians who work full-time in the secular art world, and they do keep God first. For me, I really like performing part-time. Well, one, because of my allergies. they're really debilitating. And two, because my husband's work takes us to different cities, so when we're in a big city, I perform a lot more than when we're in a little city. Some people can really make it work being a musician full time, especially if your spouse can work from home. Like, so if you have a tour or something, your spouse could come with you. In my situation, I really don't want to be away from my husband. Like, I love being with my husband so much. So I've really found peace working part-time as a musician. Another thing that is frustrating is people don't understand why churches pay musician. Again, with someone off the street can sing Gather Us In. And so they don't understand why musicians are paid. And that's so frustrating because someone off the street can't sing Brahms and Palestrina and Bruckner. And it is real work. It takes time to develop the skills. And if you hire professional musicians at your church, you can bring the volunteer musicians to a higher level. You can offer a larger quantity of music because the professionals can lead the volunteers, so you don't have to spend as much time in rehearsal. You know, if the volunteers cannot get a measure of music, the professional or the section leader can lead that measure and all the other volunteers are just, you know, kind of listening and like tagging along. So I have been so blessed to work part-time for the church as a musician ever since I graduated, and I've loved it. And I've been so blessed to always work for a Catholic church too. The Protestants really understand this, actually. There are always jobs for musicians at Protestant churches, I have found in several cities. They are just really aware of how musicians can really bring people closer to God, can assist in prayer, can promote healing for funerals or when people are going through a hard time. I can't tell you how many times people have come up to me after a funeral with just so much appreciation, like, you've really helped like heal my heart. And it's such a beautiful service, and it's really just God working through me. And I'm so blessed that God works through me. Another frustrating thing when people don't understand why the church hires musicians: you can hire a professional plumber or bring in a volunteer plumber, and that's going to be a different service. If the volunteer plumber is Catholic, he may offer his services for free sometimes, but he has to eat too. So he has to charge for his services most of the time. And, you know, same goes for if you want a beautiful mural of Jesus in your church. You can pay a professional artist, or you can bring in a volunteer. There's value in both, but you're going to get a different mural depending on who you bring in. And the same goes for musicians. Volunteer musicians are great. They have a lot of value. They can sing hymns strongly. And professional musicians can bring a higher quality of music, a higher quantity of music. Renaissance, polyphonic music, Gregorian chant, oratorio. I love that the church understands art and art's place in the world, how it's important. God is first, but art is very important in bringing people to God. Pope Paul VI in 1967 said, "The church has a need for saints, but it also has a need for artists, for strong and good artists. Both saints and artists bear testimony to the living spirit of Christ." Even if you're not a professional artist, definitely explore your creative side. It is so wonderful, and it's a gift from God. We are created in God's image. God created us, and so it's so beautiful for us to create as God creates. We create children, create art, architecture. There's so many ways to get creative, like photo books. I love photo books and photo gifts in general. I give people photo gifts all the time. Getting creative with food and cooking. YouTube is very creative. I'm not that crafty. I'm so anti-Pinterest because, you know, I can't create perfect crafts like that. But I do like doing some crafts, you know, that are easy. Like I've made little desserts shaped like high-heeled shoes out of like cupcakes and cookies and Tootsie Rolls for friends' bachelorettes. Like I love doing like cutesy, crafty things like that for kids as well. My children's choir that I teach in the current city that I'm in, I made them little Bibles out of Hershey's chocolate nuggets. You can see that video. Your creative efforts might make you a better mother. The author mentions that in the book. It's important to have creative time with kids. I would love to teach a future child like beginning ballet and tap. Even though I'm not a professional dancer, I do know the basics. You can learn right along with your kids. I could go on and on about all the things you could teach your children, but I'll just focus right now on reading music and teaching your child how to play piano. This is the book that I bought for my nephew. If you don't have a musical background and you're not ready to invest in lessons, this book is really great to get your child started on reading music and playing piano. The book comes with stickers, and it clearly shows you exactly where to place the stickers. So you place the stickers directly on your keyboard, and you see there's a cat for C, a dog for D, etc. This first song, for example, Mary Had a Little Lamb, it starts with elephant, dog, cat, dog. So to start this piece, you will play elephant, dog, cat, dog. E, D, C, D. And so you see, you can already read a full measure of music even if you don't have any musical background or any musical skill. I am so passionate about music. Even Einstein credits music for his theory of relativity. Einstein also said if he weren't a physicist, he would be a musician. There have been studies on Mozart, so people listen to Mozart before taking reasoning tests, and the people that listened to Mozart performed much better. There's a strong correlation between empathy and music. Empathetic people, when they listen to music, the parts of the brain that are associated with anything social, like communication, is activated. So there is a strong correlation between empathy and music. So music could possibly increase empathy in humans. And if you're not really into psychology, there are certain people who really suffer in that area of empathy, and they don't have that, what we think to be natural, to empathize with someone who's in pain or going through something tough. Some people don't empathize. So music could possibly be the answer. St. Augustine is often quoted saying, "He who sings well prays twice." I don't believe it was St. Augustine. I don't know who said it. I've researched and tried to find who originally said it, but I think during St. Augustine's time, it was just everyone agreed that if you sing well, you pray twice. And obviously for children, teaching children with music is so beneficial. You can teach children prayers, their numbers and letters, and you can teach children so many things so much faster with music. Music really facilitates learning. And I'm not a licensed music therapist, but music therapists help children with learning disabilities. They help them to learn something that they may be struggling with through music. It's really fabulous. Music therapists also work with the elderly. I have seen an elderly person who was just completely nonverbal, but when the music therapist came in, they remember the words to the songs and they sing and they're happy. Music is very healing. I love in the book, the author mentions Pope John Paul II. He said, "God therefore called man into existence, committing to him the craftsman's task. Through his artistic creativity, man appears more than ever in the image of God, and he accomplishes this task above all in shaping the wondrous material of his own humanity and then exercising creative dominion over the universe which surrounds him. With loving regard, the divine artist passes on to the human artist a spark of his own surpassing wisdom, calling him to share in his creative power. Last rant. Someone recently didn't understand why I worked as a musician and made the comment, you know, oh, you should really spend your weekends with your husband. I do spend my weekends with my husband, but sometimes I work, and it was just so frustrating to me. You wouldn't say that to a nurse who works part-time. I just don't understand the disconnect with why people don't respect music. It's like because they can sing row, row, row your boat, they think all music is the same, and because they're not paid to sing row, row, row your boat, why are you paid to be a musician? It's so frustrating. I hope I haven't rambled too much. I hope I've done this subject justice because I love the arts so much. I love music so much. It's so powerful. It promotes peace. It brings people closer to God. I love the arts. Definitely get creative, but obviously keep God first and just thank God for the arts and all the creative talents that He's given us. I hope you have a wonderful Thursday and a wonderful weekend. Bye-bye.